Biopesticides and bioinsecticides are being used in the garden more and more often, and it's great because it's much safer than using chemical pesticides and fungicides. Unfortunately, as it's a very new type of product for home gardeners, more and more mistakes are being made because people do not know how to use it. After watching this video, you would be more advanced and proficient than most of the home gardeners in using biological products such as biopesticides and biofungicides, and hopefully avoid all the mistakes that I'm going to mention today. So let's start. Before I start though, I want to exactly say what I mean as biopesticides and biofungicides. There is no worldwide agreed definition, and every country defines it in a different way. Even EU and USA have different definitions. So in this particular video, I'm going to talk about all the products that are based on live bacteria, fungi, or any other microorganism. So for example, Hay bacillus is a bacteria which is known in agriculture since 19th century, and it has been used very widely even before invention of antibiotics. Unfortunately, after that, its use stopped somehow, especially in human health, but now it's being used more and more. Similarly, all other bioproducts have also, in my opinion, fascinated way of discovery and fascinating results by using them, but only if you know what mistakes to avoid. The first mistake is not giving them enough time to activate before use. This is a mistake in case of the powdered form of biofungicide and bioinsecticides. So you can have them as a liquid formula, or you can have them as powder. Why would you use a powder? Because usually it can store for longer than the liquid one. However, if you use the liquid form, when you prepare solution, you can immediately add it to your solution and start using. However, with the powdered form, you have to wait until it's activated. Usually what you need to do is in an area where there is no direct sunlight, in a shade, you take amount of the powder that you need, mix it with a little bit of water, about a glass of water, non-chlorinated water, and then waiting for about half an hour before this pore forms, dry forms, activate and start becoming living forms, and then you can use it. Another mistake is actually waiting too long before using your solution. Because your solution generally does not contain nutrients for those bacteria, if you wait more than a few hours, then they will start dying because they do not have nutrients to live. So it's very important that when your solution is ready, when you prepare it, that you start spraying immediately. The third mistake is using tap water. Tap water generally contains chlorine because you want to kill all the bacteria, fungi, and other pathogens in water before drinking it or using for cooking or using for anything else. However, they are also going, this chlorine in this water is also going to kill those live bacteria and fungi in your preparations. So you should use non-chlorinated water, ideally raining water, water from a well, if you're not treating it. However, if there is no way for you to do it, then you can just take a usual tap water and wait for several days in open, put water in open container and wait for several days for this chlorine to evaporate. The fourth mistake is using both biological fungicides or insecticides and non-biological inorganic pesticides or fungicides. So what's happening is that let's say you put your organic ones, then you put the bacteria on your plant, they start working, and then you are using your inorganic ones and you are immediately killing everything that you created. So basically it's a waste of money which you spend on those microorganisms. Another way is that you used pesticides, for example. Maybe let's say many people use it, for example, solutions of copper in spring, maybe somewhere around February, March, April, depending on where you live and the weather, and then you use your organic pesticides later. So what happened is that your inorganic pesticides are still there because most of them have a very long period of becoming safe for the environment. So then when you add your biological pesticides and insecticides, they immediately dying because of still this remaining inorganic ones in your garden. So you cannot use both, because then biological wouldn't be effective. You have to make your decision that from now on, I'm switching on to biological ones, and that's gonna be my routine, and I'm going to exclude all inorganic pesticides, insecticides, fungicides from my gut. You will not regret. Mistake is using them at the wrong time of the day. Because these are leaf bacteria, they need moisture for them to live and to spread. So the idea is that you need to keep as this moisture on your plants as long as possible. For this, usually it is recommended to spray your plants in the evening after sunset, because then first of all water is going to stay longer, because it's colder and because there is no sunshine, and secondly also because there is now no ultraviolet to kill those plants. So at least they will be working through the whole night until the morning. If you spray at daytime or even in the morning, then that wouldn't be happening. Your lucky days also are days when there is no sun and the weather is a little bit sad. Then you can also spray them the whole day. Another mistake is forgetting taking into the account rain. When you spray your plants, what will happen if rain comes is that the rain will just wash away everything that you put in on the plant. So in order to prevent this, there are a few things that you can do. The first one is check the weather. Try not to spray right before the rain. Second one is use something that would ensure that that your solution sticks better. Usually there is a polymer that reduces the water tension, and then it's able to stick better to the plants or to the soil where you applied it. Another mistake is wrong storage conditions. First of all your biopreparates, biological insecticides and pesticides, should be stored in dark conditions without access of ultraviolet, because it has negative impact on the life of microorganisms. Also read about the storage conditions. Depending on how it was prepared and how it was packaged, there are different variations. It can be from a few months until 1 year or even more. It can be also at different temperatures. Many of them are recommended to be kept in the fridge, but never freeze them, because then they will die. So there are a lot of conditions which depends on what you bought. So do read very carefully and follow what's written on the menu. One more mistake is not spraying it thoroughly, especially from the bottom of the leaves. Not only because of the reasons that I already told, but also because most of the diseases and pests start spreading from the bottom of the leaves. There are many reasons for this. For example, those pathogens that are contained in the soil and they come with the drops of rain to your plants, it's much easier for them to come to the bottom of the leaves than to the top. Also, it's cooler, there is more humidity, so they are better surviving than on the top of the leaf, so there are higher survival rates. Similarly for the pests, where this is where they are hiding from predators, and many other reasons. But for you, what's important to know is that when you are spraying, spray thoroughly from the bottom of all leaves and from the top as well. Biofungicides are not systemic, so there needs to be a contact with pathogen or with pests. Therefore, thorough spraying all over the plant, including from the bottom of the leaf, including branches, including even soil around, that's how you should apply organic bioinsecticides and biofungicides. And the last reason is only using them once and then being disappointed and forgetting about them and going back using chemical preparations. So what happened is that you do have a natural situation of different microorganisms in your garden. And when you add, let's say, good microorganisms, then they are temporarily start fighting bad microorganisms. However, with time, your conditions in the garden are those that were before spraying. So with time, everything goes back to the balance. So you need to keep spraying regularly in order to add those good microorganisms to you, to your garden's microbiome. That's why the overall recommendation for biological pesticides, insecticides, fungicides is to add them every 10 to 14 days if everything looks fine with your garden, and more often if there are diseases or if there are pests. Similarly, biopesticides or any pesticides don't work on all forms of the pests. So maybe they work on adult forms while larvae is still there. So then even if you kill all your adult forms, in a few days your larvae comes back and you will see them again thinking what happened. So again, repeating applications of bio products is the best way to ensure continuous health of your gut. These are the key mistakes. However, in my other videos, for which I recommend you to subscribe so you don't miss them, I will be also talking about biopesticides and biofungicides and specific usage of them for different plants. So do subscribe and don't miss them. As of now, I do recommend you to look for my other video, which is about all the different plant diseases and how to prevent them. And using biofungicides is only one way of doing it. There are 12 more.